women doctors, we hear you. We know your struggles. We know what it's like to be a female doctor in this dominant world. And guess what? Dr. Summer Casmel and myself teamed up together and created Women Dentists Connect. We wanted to create a safe, educational, and inspirational place to come and ask those crazy questions that you don't want to ask. We know that being a female doctor is different than it is for male doctors. You just have different issues, different questions, different concerns. So Dr. Summer Casmel and I are actually hosting a live event in beautiful Scottsdale, Arizona on October 11th and 12th. This is for women doctors and their teams. We're talking business. We're talking issues that female doctors face. We're talking team breakouts, how to really rally your team. And we're giving you hundreds of tangibles that you can take home and implement Monday morning. We're also having an amazing lineup of speakers where you'll actually get CE for attending. So come on in. We can't wait to see you. We only have a handful of people that we're allowing in. So run on over to womendentistconnect.com. Use the coupon code podcast to get the Dental 18 family coupon. Guys, I cannot wait. I would love to see you there. I'd love to connect with you, learn from you, and share. So hop on over, Women Dentists Connect. I can't wait to see you in October. Hey, everyone. Welcome to the Dental 18 podcast. We're your hosts, Kira Dent.
And Dr. Mark Costas.
Mark and I had this crazy idea that maybe we could combine a dentist and a team member's perspective. Because let's face it, dentistry can be a challenging profession with those two perspectives. And Dental 18 Podcast was created.
I'm a practicing dentist, a multiple practice owner, a dental performance coach, and the founder of the Dental Success Institute.
I've been a dental assistant, treatment coordinator, scheduler, biller, office manager, current practice owner, and international dental consultant. Mark and I don't just understand you, we are you.
Our goal is to positively impact the world of dentistry by sharing our lessons learned from the road in hundreds of dental offices.
Two perspectives, one mission, to help dental professionals reach their full potential. Welcome to the Dental 18 Podcast. Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode of the Dental 18 Podcast. I'm Kira Dent, and I am just jazzed because I just got done speaking with Dr. Dunning. He works with UNMC, which is the University of Nebraska College of Dentistry. And I just got to speak, you guys, super cool. I spoke to some dental students in, they're hanging out in Jamaica right now. So they all get there. Shoot, I should have just gone to Jamaica, but instead I Skype called in. I absolutely love, love, love speaking to dental students. I love speaking to large audiences. So if any of you have ever wondered, do I speak to students? Absolutely 100% reach out. I'd be more than happy to speak to your alma maters. If you have friends that are in dental school, I would love, love, love. I love it. It's so fun to, it's fun to inspire them. It's fun to, and to just be Kira Dent from the block. I'm not a dentist. I'm nobody scary. Ask me any question. I love it. And I worked with all the dental students at Midwestern. So of course, I absolutely 100% love it. Just makes me excited and it's just fun for me. So I just got off my call with them and we talked about hiring and firing. You guys know, those are like my go-tos. We've got the hiring course. We have our episode, Are You Hiding Your Dirty Laundry? So go back and listen to that episode. If you haven't checked out our hiring course, go to thedentalateam.com. Use the coupon code HIRE7 to get it for lucky $7.77. It's really funny to me. I still think it's hilarious. But what I want to talk about is disciplinary action. So firing, I've talked about this before, but it just kind of sparked it back up for me of disciplinary action. What do you do? So you should be doing monthly self-assessments. If you're not, stop right now, pull up your calendar, stick it in your calendar, 15 minutes. I will send you assessment forms. I don't care. Get these things done. Confession, this is truth. I just put it into play in my own company 3 months ago. Yes, I know. I've been talking and I've had a company for how long? Gosh, 2.5 years now? What am I doing? I preach this all day long, but I'm not doing it. So seriously, stop the podcast right now. Come back to it, but literally put those self-assessments in your calendar if you're not doing it. Just meet with your team, make your life easy, stop putting it off. What we put off today, come on now, you got this. Actually, let me pull up a cool quote from Mark Costas where he talks about this very thing. Okay, so that quote is, what successful people do consistently, normal people do occasionally. And holy mother, I love this one because I think about it a lot when I'm, you know, not wanting to work out in the morning. Like, what am I doing consistently? So stop right now, consistently put those reviews in there because that's going to help with your disciplinary action. So let's say hypothetical, You're doing these reviews. You're checking in. Now, what do you do next? They're still not performing. Kaylee and I just had our quarterly meeting. So we were looking at this employee thinking, they're not who we want. They're not the person that we're wanting. They're not doing the things that we keep asking them. But what happened was they weren't, it wasn't them. It was us. It was all us. We realized we did not have a strong enough KPI. We didn't have a set check-in and we hadn't clearly communicated that expectation to them. So jury's still out. We're going to change it. But I'm not going to just terminate this person because I looked at myself. What was I not doing to make this person successful? Now, if you're doing everything, you've given them every single tool for success. Bottom line is people have to choose. They have to want it. They have to decide, yes, I'm going to go do this. I will do these things. And if not, guess what? This isn't the place for them. It's not their dream job. And that is okay. It is okay to not have somebody on your team that they like. They can move on. That's totally fine. Let them go find their dream job. Spread their wings and go. So now with the probationary period, when somebody goes on probation, I usually have it for 30 days. So we're checking in every single week. But before you're there, check yourself. That's why I wanted to talk about it. Because when I finally checked myself, I realized the bigger problem was I hadn't set clear expectations. I hadn't put forth the expectation to give me the results I was looking for. That was on me, not on the employee. Beautiful. Take that ownership. Go read Extreme Ownership right now if you haven't read it. Learn that because that's going to be on you. See what you're doing and what you're putting out there that's not giving you the results you're looking for. All right, done. All those things are checked. Check, check, check. We're solid. We're doing our assessments. We've set the proper standards. We read, Extreme Ownership. We are solid. We know this. This person is just not our A-team player. Sweet. 30-day probationary period. At that point, they go on probation. Nobody should ever be surprised when they are fired, right? We've talked about this. You know this. No one should ever be surprised when they are fired. So bring them in. Hey, Kara, do you know why you're here? Yeah, I do. I get ones on all my assessments. Dang it. Yeah. How do you feel about this? Is this your dream job? It is. All right. How bad do you want it? I really want it. Okay. So I'm going to put you on 30-day probation. I've already given you a verbal warning. I've given you a written warning and now we're on probation. Like here we are. This is where we are. We're not going to keep playing this game. Our goal is to identify, discuss, solve it forever. We are solving this forever. These are the three biggest issues. Let's improve those over the next 30 days. I want you here. That's why I'm spending time talking to you. Come into my office. I'm talking to you. I want you here. I'm going to meet with you every single week. I'm a busy person. So for me to give you every single week, like clearly I want you here. If you want to be here, I'm going to do everything in my power to make it so you can succeed. Do you want that? Yes. What are you willing to put into this to make sure you succeed? I'm going to do this. Be specific, like get real specific, nitty gritty with me. Make them do this, guys. Then you can see, do they really want it? Because it also could be a quick reality check and make it easier for you. No, this isn't what I want to do. Sweet. Let's both move on and find our perfect way. This is you quitting on your own. Let's sign this paperwork and move on. Great. They do that. Move on. It's beautiful. If not, they're going to ask them specifically. Okay, these are the three things I need you to work on. What are you specifically going to do to make sure you get there? Because let's set you up for success. Let's not just go along as we've been going, status quo, hoping you change in a miraculous way. What are you going to do? Give me some specifics. I'm going to do these things. Awesome. Can't wait. I'm going to meet with you next week. Let's put it on the calendar so we're both accountable to it. Beautiful. See you next week. Let's go over these three things. Are you hitting them? Are you not hitting them? Great. The next week, same thing. I can't tell you how many times I have seen team members turn around when this takes place. It's super crazy town. It's crazy how much they turn around and then it becomes awesome. They don't want to stop meeting with you every week. And you're like, we gotta cut the cord. You got to move on. Like, this is great. I'm so happy. I'm glad we worked on this. It can just be something that simple. Or at the end of the 30 days, it's like, whoa, no, this didn't work out. Why are you in here? Because I'm being fired today. Absolutely. Like, we knew this is what was going to happen in 30 days. You agreed to this. I agreed to this. This is where we are. We're executing on this project. So if that comes, I've heard of a few things. Once again, check your labor laws. I am not claiming to be HR. I'm not claiming to be CEDAR. I'm not claiming to be a guru on this. I am not giving you any legal advice and I will not be held accountable for this because this is labor law stuff, which is super trippy, weird to me. And I don't want you guys to ever, ever, ever get in trouble because you didn't do your research. So Kira Dent is telling you, check your labor laws. But I have seen this work very well with a few offices. Once again, if it works for your labor laws and what you're legally allowed to do, where they'll talk to them and say like, hey, Kira, we're at the 30 days. I have no desire to fire you. I don't want that on your record. I don't want you being fired from a job. I don't want to do that. So you're welcome to voluntarily terminate. And I'm happy to even give you a severance, like $500 or whatever it is. Or I can fire you and we can go that route. It's totally your call. I would much rather not fire you though. The team member then has an opportunity to not be fired. They can voluntarily quit on their own. They sign a form saying they voluntarily quit and move on. Once again, like, I don't want to fire somebody. I have no desire. I don't want that on their record. Now, if they've done something bad, something where they stole from the company or something, they stole patient information or they broke laws. Yep, you got to fire. That's just downright termination. Make sure during that 30-day probationary period, you're also documenting very, very well. So that way you have written record. They have it signed. You have it signed. You can turn those things in. I have an office in Texas. She's phenomenal at winning these unemployment battles. Fantastic. Documentation is key. So if any of you guys want help, email us. I'm happy to connect you with her. She's great. She's phenomenal. She's had a lot of unemployment cases she's won. But nobody should ever be surprised. Guys, are you taking the time to invest in your employees to make sure that they're playing the rules right and that they know the rules? Are you taking the time to help them get on the same page with you? If not, that's on you. Have that be on you. Take ownership for that. Then do your probationary period. And then I do love that. Have a simple sweep. You should have their final check. Make sure you withhold things and then do a checklist at the end. You escort them out. Tell them, thanks for working here. You don't have to apologize. You don't have to say sorry. You don't have to say we wish this would have worked out. They know. There was no surprise on it. They know why they're being terminated. You went for a whole month with them. They know. So you escort them out. I hate this part. It's the most uncomfortable part of all of it. I've had them sign the form. I give them their final check and I escort them out of the building. They go pick up their stuff. Off they go. I personally like to do it at the end of the day, not the beginning of the day. Just seems to be a better way to end the day. But that's how I do it. But then make sure you're checking things. Make sure you don't have any remote login access. I had a hygienist one time, personal story, remote in, snag a whole patient list. And it was because I didn't remove her login. That was dumb on my part. I didn't remove her login to our computer software. I didn't remove her login to our alarm system. I didn't get her key before she left. I didn't keep the money that she owed us for scrubs out of her final paycheck. Check for those things to make sure those things are done prior to termination. You know it's coming, so make sure you have your ducks in a row. That way everything is prepared, ready to go, and firing and that disciplinary action doesn't have to be a hard thing. It's part of being in a business. People come and go. That is part of being in a business. If you don't want to do it, don't be in a business. That is just part of it. People grow. Businesses grow. You outgrow certain people. That's okay. Give them the opportunity to rise with you. And if they want to, they will. And if not, perfect. Help them find their dream job. It's perfect. It's great for both parties. All right, guys, there's your tactical probationary. I know we've talked about firing, but I just came off of that call and I thought, okay, check yourself. That was something I had to just recently do. Something I don't always do. I'm like, God, just get out of here. I'm sick of dealing with this. You're just not being accountable. Like, I'm over this. Like, let's find somebody else. No, it's way easier to train people if they're willing to learn than having to go find great loyal people. This employee is a phenomenally loyal person. There's just a few things that I haven't trained her on. That's on me. I need to do better. And then if she chooses not to follow, then it's on her. Remember, the things that we can do consistently are what we get. I also heard another really, really, really fantastic quote. Practice does not make perfect. Practice makes permanent. What's being practiced in your practice? That was a clever play on words. Practice makes permanent. Are we tolerating certain behaviors that they're practicing over and over and over again? Those become permanent. What things are you doing that are permanent because you're practicing them day in, day out? Practice does not make perfect. Practice makes permanent. All right, guys, that's your Dental Aid Team tip for you today. Go out, make it a fantastic day. Thank you as always for joining me, and I'll catch you next time on the Dental Aid Team podcast. That wraps it up for another episode of the Dental Aid Team podcast. Thank you so much for listening, and we'll talk to you next time.